For thousands of years, people didn't know what causes thunder and lightning. Huge bolts of electricity come out of the sky and split open trees. Dark fires, but it's all followed by huge pools. So people made up a story about a guy named Zeus who lived in a cloud every once in a while. He threw a bolt of lightning down to Earth. Seemed like a pretty good explanation, so people believed it for a long time. But it turns out it's even wilder than that. Lightning is caused by tiny pieces of stuff called electrons, and they rub on each other for huge amounts of energy to build up the cloud. And then, that! Lightning bolts come down to the Earth. Anyway, just because something is unexplained doesn't mean that it's psychic or magic or mystic. That just means that we can't explain it right now. We're trying to find answers to things we don't understand. That's part of being human. It's human nature. It's why we have science. I guess probably we have pseudoscience.
Alright, boss, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Astrology started out as the study of the emotions of stars and planets. Most astrologers take it a step farther than that. They claim they can tell a lot about a person's personality just by knowing when you were born. Now that's a claim that's pretty hard to prove. Now in 2,000 years ago, astrologers believed that the Earth was at the center of everything, and the stars and planets were attached to a big dome or sphere. They use names for groups of stars, and we still call them constellations. This one's supposed to be a fish. Now if we can go way out in space and look at the same group of stars like this. Well, we wouldn't see a fish anymore. Anyway, it is interesting to note that the gravitational pull of all the stars in this constellation is way less than a trillionth of a gravitational pull between you and the television set you're watching right now. Does that mean astrology is wrong?
Astrophysics is now beginning to descend.
Well, astrologers may claim that they can be proven or disproven. They're vague. They're wishy-washy. Now that's not science. It's, well, you decide.
So you don't need mystical powers. You don't have to be psychic to lay on a bed of nails. The nails are so close together, and your weight gets so spread out that not any one nail gets you. Unless you move around the wrong way. Yeah, it's not mystic, it's not psychic, it's science. It's hard to raise your head, because then your shoulders dig in. You don't want that, you don't want that. You've got to have the pillow.
I hear you.
You have to have the pillow. That's why you see those guys wear those turbans.
Yeah, otherwise your head would leak.
Yeah.
What is he doing on that merry-go-round?
Looks extraordinary, doesn't it? When you see something like this carousel, take a moment. Does it have an extraordinary cause, or is there really a simple explanation looking at it from a different angle?
School for the factory, from pocket money to a salary, from a pack of Mac to a compact case, and every morning she inspects her face. She discovers pulling pints in pubs that the good looks will never cover up for her dumbness in taking the stock. Sees her reflection in a butcher's shop. She finds it all quite rare that her meat's all Vanity Fair. She finds it all quite rare. it's all Vanity Fair. She has her eyes on medallion men that get her home on the dot at 10. She combs her hair when she gets excused. The deal she wants always ends up screwed. Paints her nails on the bathroom scales. Goggles her breath like a landed whale. Her beauty is as deep as her skin. Keeps her eyebrows in a tobacco tin. She poses foot on a chair. Coconut shy but Vanity Fair. She poses foot on a chair. Coconut shy but Vanity Fair. In her vanity case, her compact case, in her compact case, her eyes. Not bad for a sister, but her vanity's fair and her sense of humor's dry. She comes home late with another screw loose. She swears to have had just a pineapple juice. Falls asleep fully clothed in her bed with her makeup remover by her head. And she might not be all there, but her dreams are Vanity Fair. She might not be all there, but her dreams are Vanity Fair.
Real